Today on the Skid Factory, we're going to extract some more power from my Harrop-blown big block Chev. Welcome back to the Skid Factory. Last time you would have seen the crown on the show, we did a little bit of a overview of the build, how much it costs, what went wrong, what still needed to be done. You can probably find that here if Woody does his job right, maybe there. I've been driving it a fair bit since then, or not a fair bit, but you know, on Sunday drives, just cruising around, just enjoying it after all that work. One thing that was immediately obvious, even on the first sort of drive, was the radiator wasn't really up to it. So I have addressed that. I've replaced the radiator with, it's kind of like the same, it's from the same family as the Skyline radiator, but it's 25% larger, so it now goes right down to the bottom of the stone tray. And I've made just a bracket to support it out of chromoly. So that's working really well. I've taken it for a fair few drives now. It's getting hotter and hotter here. It's sort of getting into summer, so it seems to be coping really well. So I'm pretty stoked with that. Now we can sort of move towards maybe trying to get a bit more power out of it. On the dyno, we ran out of fuel, so we sort of undersized the fuel system for what it needed. It's a big thirsty beast. So what we're going to do today before we head to the dyno is replace the 1200cc injectors with a new set of Raceworks 1500cc, or they're 15 to 1650 depending on the fuel pressure. So they're going to go in, and we've also got another fuel pump to go in next to the pump that's in the cell already. So that will be then staged in via the Haltech PD16. When required. So let's get stuck into fitting those up and see how much power this thing wants to give me. I'm that guy that fills his fuel tank up just before he brings it in to get the pump removed. That's right. Got the second Raceworks pump fitted up. I had a little bit of fiddling around with wiring to do, as the brushless pump has four wires. What I've ended up doing, because I just spent an hour or so or two looking for the insulated bolts that I got from Raceworks and couldn't find them because we did a cleanup, and that means stuff goes wherever. I've just elected to take the ground off one of these posts and share the ground. So I did test it before I pulled it out, and the ground it goes directly to the battery with no ignition system or anything on. So. That should be all right. So we've got a shared ground there that'll then go off to via the control box to the battery, and we've got that as the new positive for the second pump. So that'll go back in now, and I'll do some wiring, and then we can get back up the front and pull those injectors out and replace them. She's all wired and plumbed up. I got a T-piece down there with the second hose going straight into the fuel pressure regulator. I had spare wiring there from the PD16 in the boot, so we just have to configure that to switch that second pump on. I'll probably leave that up to Kai because he'll probably know what point to turn it on. All we've got to do now is go up the front and swap out those 1200cc injectors for some 1500s, and then we can hit the dyno. We'll be right back. Injectors are all fitted up. They're a little bit difficult to get in there, but I made it work. It's probably about the third time I've done it, so I should be good at it by now. I've run up the car, I started it, fuel pressure, everything looks sweet, no leaks, so we're good to go. I'm just doing a quick oil change, some fresh oil in it before we head down to the dyno. I'll top her up with some lemon squash racing oil, only the finest grade, and we'll be good to go. Trailered the car down here this morning to Knight Family Motorsport with Kai. We're going to throw it back up on the dyno and try to extract the best we can out of it. We have already tuned it just when we finished it to get ready to go to the formal way back. Now we've made the necessary changes to the fuel system and that, and I've also changed the pulley system to lower the boost pressure because it had a pretty aggressive setup on it, 18-20 psi sort of thing. So now it's back on it, and what, from a tuning point of view, what are we looking for here, Kai?
So the big things for me is we've changed the injectors. Obviously, we've changed the pulley. The pulley's not a huge deal, but the injectors does mean that we've changed the fuel characterization in the engine. So we go through, we need to get the fueling back on again. We are now going to be able to push to boost levels higher than we previously were, because before we were limited by the fuel system. So yeah, it'll be interesting to see what this pulley system does, see how much boost it's geared up for, and see what it can do.
So we don't actually know what the pulley system's going to do, because this is obviously the prototype for the entire setup. So Harrop's just sent me a pulley, bolted it on, got the appropriate belt. We're kind of doing the sort of guinea pig work, I suppose, at the end of the day, but someone's got to do it and we're keen, so let's get stuck into it. Guy's done a couple of quick runs, one with the flap open, so the lowest boost possible, and then followed by one with the like the bypass shut, so the highest boost possible. And what's happened?
So yeah, it's brought the boost back to a much more manageable level. It's now making around about sort of 10.5-ish pounds of boost. That's put it out on that first pull, which we haven't really got after it yet, but it made 700 just on that first hit. So that's looking pretty promising. We've still got heaps of fuel system. The second fuel pump now, the fuel pressure's staying dead level at 60 psi. So we've got heaps of fuel system. We're only around about sort of, I think it's 55 to 56% on the in the injectors now, because we've got the bigger ones. So everything's looking really, really nice there.
So from here, given that we can only get 10.5 psi boost, how do we go?
So from here, exactly, if we can't get any more boost into the engine, which we can't, then what we'll be looking at doing is optimizing fuel mixtures and ignition timing and stuff like that. This doesn't have variable cam timing or other fun, fancy stuff that modern engines have, but that's where we go from here.
Okay, cool. So is there a machine shop nearby that could possibly make a...
smaller pulley? To fingers.
Hey, can I ask a question too? How does that fuel pump, is that staged in or is that just adding on, yeah?
Yeah, so the way I've configured it is the brushless pump was already variable, so it's variable speed, and then we've also got the second pump being switched on once it's seeing beyond about sort of 55% load, so that we're not constantly circulating fuel unnecessarily and causing heat in the fuel system and all the rest of it, and also then like high load on the electrical system, because this car does have quite a lot of electrical loads. It's got fans, it's got intercooler pumps, it's got all kinds of stuff on it, so yeah, we are staging that.
Sweet.
Thank you. we're pretty much done with the actual tuning side of things. Like, that's the power it's making. It's only got 10 PSI boost, so that's all we're getting. Everything is optimized. It's 713, I think, was the last figure we saw, which is great. That's plenty. It's also got like 750 pound feet of torque, which is quite a bit. So it should do the job. What's happening now is Kai's just fiddling around with the some race timers and stuff like that, because I'm going to race it on the weekend at Willowbank. So he's setting it up. So transbrake release starts a timer, and then he's got a sort of a boost control strategy working on the control over the bypass valve and the supercharger, because it makes like maximum torque pretty much on the transbrake, doesn't it? So yeah. That doesn't usually work out too well unless you've got some big boots. It's only got 255s on it, which is reasonable grip, but probably not enough for the both my experience, which is nothing, and and also the track and the power. So
I doubt we're going to have a radial prep down there. Like, this is just it's a Christmas party essentially at the drag strip. So the prep at the track will be, I'd say they'll probably only glue it maybe once or twice throughout the whole day. So we're going to be dealing with a marginal track. There's going to be a lot of street tires going down. So it's not going to be like a killer Kenda track or something like that. So what we're doing is like 700 horsepower to perspective, like we're in the Mark's Fairlane. That leaving with like 600 horsepower was pulling the wheels up, you know what I mean? This is a very similar weight car, similar combination. If we try and let Al leave straight off the trans brake with all the boost, because it's a PD blower, it leaves with everything straight away, it'll probably either blow the tyres off, or it'll definitely probably do a fairly decent wheelie straight off the hit, which it'll be one of those things that's, Al can grow into that, let's put it that way. So what we're going to do is we're going to have the bypass open on the blower when it leaves, and then we're going to progressively close it during the 60 foot so that the power will come in progressively. So the first proper passes will probably be really nice and sedate, and we may end up going back to just leaving the bypass closed and just letting it have all the power, but this will be a good way to go to the track and do a first test pass.
So the difference here is you normally don't have that control over a PD blower. Using that boost control valve on the Harrop bypass valve there, it gives you a lot greater level of control without having to take timing out or shut the throttle, which is obviously not ideal. So it means that I don't have to think about as much, which is great because I haven't got much brain space left, and I also have absolutely no experience in driving a fast car on a racetrack. So we'll see what happens. Should be fun.
Hey Kyle, you look really good tough arming in the crown, by the way.
I'm feeling it.
Get some sunscreen on that bad
bubble love. Yeah, definitely need sunscreen.
That's going to be it for the crown for the moment. 700 horsepower at the hubs is more than enough for me for the moment. I've got to learn how to drive it at the track, and that's going to be a new experience for me. So I'm stoked. You can always add bigger pulleys or smaller pulleys or a combination of both later, and I think there's probably a bit more left in the old Girlette yet, but this is the problem, not the engine. Big thanks to Kai from Knight Family Motorsport, as always. Excellent tuning job, excellent communicator. He's an asset to our channel, so thanks very much, mate. He's just currently installing a womp switch onto the Haltech CAN keypad, and I'm going to need that because I'm taking the crown to Summonats 35, 5th to the 8th of January in Canberra at Epic Showgrounds. It's going to be awesome. I'm going to be womping around pretending and I'm running on methanol and poorly tuned. Well, that's what the switch is for anyway. It's going to be fun. If you're in the area, head down. It's always a good experience, and it is a bumper year. It's been held up a bit in the last few years with COVID and stuff. It's absolutely sold out. Heaps of cars. It's going to be epic, as the name suggests, for the showgrounds. Also going to have a sneaky Bedford van with me, so look out for that one as well. We'll see you there.
Hey, thanks for watching.
Oh, thanks for watching, of course.
Seems like you've had a hard time trying to make this thing not run properly.
It's difficult.
still on the throttle bypass up and down.
Yeah, I set all that to do that, yeah.
You've seen it's got actually got lock switch on it?
Is it? Swap switch or ghost cam?
The boat.
Ghost swap.
Why don't we have both?
How good's that, bud? You're essentially just like...
That ejecto Cito in his own.
Ejecto Cito, cuz! I reckon Unleash the Beast is the closest one.
Is that... So is that in gear?
No. It's probably going to be super cranky.
Oh yeah,
it's going to be good.
Don't forget, Summonats 35, 5th to 8th of January in Canberra. You want to check out what it's like? Here's a video from last year. If you want to buy tickets, click here. Otherwise, we'll see you there. Australia's Horsepower Party. Thanks for watching.